Guttenberg parents and teachers alike continue to question Board of Education members about what the circumstances would be should they send their children to the 7th and 8th grade schools in North Bergen.
During the public portion of the meeting, Sari Zuckerman, a former board member, said that research shows children typically perform better in a K-8 environment than they do when transferred to a middle school.
It has been shown in all the research. If you go back and read some of it, go back and read Diane Ravitch, go back and read some of the research that's been done. It shows that children will suffer behavioralized and academically when they are moved from a K-8 environment to a middle school. So that's my feeling about the concept of education in middle school. As far as the community is concerned, I'm a concerned citizen. We built a beautiful addition, or are building a beautiful addition to hold us, house our 7th and 8th graders with the superb educational facility with every kind of educational need that there can possibly be. Why are you moving our kids out? Why are you taking them out?
Another speaker, Guttenberg parent Gladys Villegas Ocampo, said there should be no obligation for residents to send 7th and 8th grade students to North Bergen.
I personally don't like North Bergen. I like my town. I don't feel that North Bergen is a North Bergen High School, let's say. And my kid's not even going to that grade yet. But I just think that if we're staying here in this town, why should we be obligated to send our kids, 7th and 8th graders, to a town that we don't like? It's just a question. Because, yes, you are the town, and you're the board, and great. But I can't willfully sit there, and if you guys decide down the road to say yes to North Bergen, you're making a decision for my child.
Responding to another parent's concerns, Guttenberg BOE Council John Chatino said that the board would consider the educational and economic benefits before making a decision.
That's the question. Is there going to be an educational benefit? And as the board president stated, they haven't had any meetings yet. But that is going to have to be demonstrated, what those educational benefits would be. You heard Ms. Zuckerman, who was on the board for a long time, and I think she's correct. There are studies out there that talk about, you know, middle schools and some issues with middle schools. So all those factors are going to have to be considered. And at the end of the day, again, there'll be a discussion in public, and if it does not have an educational benefit and is not a cost-effective solution, then I can't speak for the board, but I just can't imagine anyone saying it's still a good idea.
During questioning from another parent, Johnny Restrepo, former board president Rebecca Vasquez said that at October press conference where North Bergen officials announced that High Tech would be the new Township High School was the first they heard that the old high school would be used for 7th and 8th graders.
I got a call from Mayor Drescher, who was at a press conference in North Bergen where this was announced about this extension, you know, Bergen, about their taking over where the High Tech is. And they're making a statement that they were going to move the 7th and 8th graders into the existing high school. The mayor right away called me. And he said, did you hear? Did you anyone call you or contact you and discuss this with you? And I said, this comes as a total shock to me. Right? And so I said, you know, at that point, I said, you know, I will discuss it and talk to the superintendent, with the business administrator, just to find out whether or not they had gotten any calls from anybody at North Bergen. And the answer was no. And so when I discussed it with both the superintendent and his administrator, I said, what we need to do is that we need to research the cost and benefit of what it would take for us to be able to send. Because right now, you know, we're spending a lot of money sending our kids over to the high school. We need to look to see what the dollars and cents is, okay, of this decision. Because this is not something that they came to us to consult us with. It was almost like an automatic assumption that that was going to happen. But at no point did they have any kind of discussion with anybody in the school board back in the fall. All right? And then at that point is when the superintendent, Jolene, and Gonzalo on the phone went over and had the meeting with them and said, look, according to our estimates, it's going to cost us, and correct me if I'm wrong, Michelle, about $2 million additional a year to send up the point.
Or something.
I'm John Hytus with the Hudson County View, the eye of the community.